Well, Auto Expo 2020 has got off to a start, and the first press conference was from Maruti Suzuki, and the biggest highlight of the Maruti Suzuki Pavilion is here, right here. It's called the Futuro-e concept, and with me I have C V Raman, Senior Executive Director, Engineering of Maruti Suzuki. Raman-san, thanks for spending your time.
Thank you.
And tell us quickly about the objective behind showcasing the Futuro-e concept this time.
Futuro-e is a new design language from Maruti Suzuki, and we believe that that is for the progressive and young aspirational Indian customer. And SUV being the theme, we felt that we should showcase the new design language on SUV concept. And for the first time, we are having a coupe style of concept in the SUV segment from Maruti Suzuki, which is having very bold proportions and a very aggressive and sporty stance. So that was the main reason to showcase the feature of it.
And how much of it is how much of the work was done in India?
Well, the entire engineering, the design of this vehicle has been done by the in-house design team. Of course, the fabrication was done outside, but the entire the concept and the thought and the entire execution was under the supervision of the Indian design team.
So, going by early instances from the Swift concept to the Espresso, the concept version of the Espresso, which was showcased in the last Auto Expo, this one. So, can we expect how soon can we expect a production version of this?
Well, as I said, this is a design concept. We are just going to understand the Indian market and what the customer is going to feel about the design. We're quite positive, but we need to get opinion from media and experts like yourself and from the public at large to understand the liking for this kind of a stance and for this kind of a proportion and for this kind of a design.
And as I understand, the platform is also made vehicle ready.
It can be done that way, because in future, if you have to keep that, but to keep that in mind when we are looking at it.
All right. And you're also focusing on hybrids, as we can see here. Could you briefly tell us about your strategy for electrifying IC engines and your CNG? Because now you have exited the diesel market.
Yeah. So our message today to the Indian public and to everybody is that Suzuki is committed to India. We believe that we are on a green mission, green million. That's the messaging which we have done. And we believe that whatever we have done in the last 10 years, we are going to do that mission of 1 million vehicles in the next couple of years.
Is that literally couple of years?
maybe the next couple of years is what we are targeting to achieve this million vehicles. And we are going through a technology agnostic approach. And we are going to show, as we have showcased, we have CNG products, we have smart hybrid technology, we have the strong hybrid technology, and we also are showcasing an e-vehicle. So I think we believe in of the volume, and we also believe that we need to make a product which is for India and which is for their needs and which is to suit their economics. So I think that's the main effort of Maruti Suzuki on this.
And as you mentioned, the concept is also to showcase your kind of designing capabilities.
Absolutely.
So do we then understand that henceforth the Maruti cars will speak a different design language?
Definitely. That is the main point which we want to make here, is that we are moving, we are progressing, and this is the new direction of that progression, starting with the design and then technology.
Right. And lastly, Raman-san, Maruti Suzuki vehicles have already always been strong for value for money proposition, fuel efficiency being a key strength. But now the safety is a growing buzzword in the Indian market among consumers too. And that is perhaps Maruti doesn't come top of mind when it comes to safety. Is there a focus on kind of enhancing that kind of quotient of Maruti cars?
Well, Well, we are always, meeting all the requirements of the Indian regulations, and recently all our products have been upgraded to meet the offset, side impact and pedestrian regulations much ahead of the time, and we've done it for all our products. So I think our commitment towards safety is demonstrated, and we also believe that safety is not just of the product, but it's about the infrastructure and it's about the ecosystem. And we are working with our dealer, through our dealerships, on Maruti driving schools, through IDTR for training commercial drivers. We are working with the Delhi police and Delhi government on traffic management system, and so on and so forth. So it's the entire thing which you need to look at going forward. And so I think safety is everybody's responsibility, so to speak. You are going to see the products are going to be meeting all these norms. And if you are referring to other regulations coming forward in future, definitely we'll be able to meet that.
You have also showcased a Swift strong hybrid.
Yeah.
Is that meant for market introduction? By when can we expect?
Well, we are showcasing technology, and based on the technology, we will be able to, and based on a particular segment, we can bring that technology to India. So that's what we are trying to showcase.
Okay. On that note, Raman-san, thank you very much.
Thank you so
much. Wishing all the best.
Thanks.
Thank you very much. And there you are, C V Raman, Senior Executive Director of Maruti Suzuki, explained to us the strategy, the thought process behind the Futuro-e concept and the overall strategy when it comes to new fuel technologies. And as the company says, it is taking a fuel agnostic approach when it comes to cleaner mobility, and of course safety is also a key focus area as the industry progresses and along with it the company grows. On that note, thank you very much for watching this interview. Goodbye.